Hi guys, and welcome back to Inside Tech. Now that summer is here, it's the perfect time for listening to music by the poolside or taking it to the beach. So today, we'll be taking a look at some top picks for portable, compact, and most importantly, water-resistant wireless speakers. Global charging tech leaders Anker have just entered their own speaker into this arena, expanding the Soundcore range with the new Motion Q, promising full water protection and 360-degree audio. In this video, we'll explore the speaker's full capabilities and compare it against proven competitors, the Sony XB10 and the UE Wonderboom, testing out the full range of features, the design, and of course, audio quality. Let's take a look. We'll start things off with the Motion Q, and I'll keep the unboxings fairly brief since we can expect something similar for each of these speakers. In typical Anker fashion, the Motion Q will launch in just a single colour variant, in contrast to the XB10 and Wonderboom, which both offer a variety of options. At the top, all of our accessories are bundled together in this blue box, with only the speaker itself underneath. Included inside here is all of our paperwork, consisting of the feedback card, safety info, and the quick start guide. We also get a micro USB cable for charging. Sadly, this mid-2018 speaker still doesn't incorporate USB-C. Finally, we have a shoelace-style hand strap. The speaker itself consists of a dark grey woven fabric that tapers into the hard plastic base and surface panels. At the rear towards the top, we also have a loophole to attach the included hand strap. Finally, at the bottom, we have a small panel to protect the 3.5mm audio and micro USB inputs. The surface panel consists of 5 controls. They're easy to press and give a distinct clicky response. An LED indicator is also featured to provide feedback for controls, Bluetooth pairing, and battery status. Turning on the device, it will immediately enter pairing mode and search for the last device it connected to. Just like the other speakers in this video, the Motion Q can pair up with a second speaker. Just long press on the Bluetooth button and the flashing white LED will indicate stereo pairing mode. Once the two are paired, the speaker with the blue LED indicates the left channel, whilst the white LED indicates the right channel. Unfortunately, there is no option to switch these channels and the speakers are locked to stereo playback. However, your music can be controlled using either speaker, and adjusting the volume does control both speakers in the stereo pair. The left channel speaker is unique in that you can activate your phone's voice assistant for giving commands or making phone calls. This can't be done using the right channel speaker, and the microphone is only activated in that same left channel speaker. When you're finished, a nice feature is that turning off either speaker will automatically turn off the other in the stereo pair. The control system as a whole is simple and intuitive, complemented by easy-to-press tactile buttons and a clear and informative LED. The microphone picked up my voice fairly well and was good enough to handle voice commands and phone calls, but I did find it a shame that this was restricted to just one of the two speakers. Of course, if you're using just a single speaker, then you won't have an issue. The Motion Q has a flawless build quality in terms of stitching and materials. The speaker feels robust and durable, and despite not being certified as shockproof, will certainly be resistant to accidental knocks or drops. With a fingerprint-resistant surface and a strong, tightly weaved fabric exterior, you can also expect the speaker to show minimal signs of wear and tear after prolonged usage. The outer material is also fast drying and easy to grip, but the bottom surface doesn't provide much resistance to slip. I can't help but feel as though some rubber feet would have been appropriate here. Hopefully though, at 416 grams, the speaker will carry enough weight to prevent accidental falls or movement. Despite the weight, the Motion Q is a sturdy, compact, and well-designed speaker. Moving on to the Sony XB10, this speaker comes from the same family as the XB40 I previously featured on the channel, and essentially the 10 is just a miniature version of that. I'll be unboxing here the black version, but unlike the Motion Q, there are a number of vibrant color alternatives to choose from. Opening up the box, we're first met with a micro USB charging cable. Underneath we have our paperwork, containing a quick start guide here in blue, the safety and warranty information, and also a full user's guide. Finally, of course, we have the speaker itself, and the first thing you'll notice is that we have a much more premium looking design. The XB10 features a color matched and top facing speaker grille, with a silicon rubber exterior. At the rear, you can see we have the NFC logo, so you are able to instantly pair with the speaker using certain Android smartphones. Underneath we have our control scheme consisting of 5 clickable buttons, with LEDs to indicate power, charging, Bluetooth pairing, and the playback mode. These controls offer a more precise and satisfying click when pressed, but they do require a bit more pressure to trigger than with the Motion Q. At the end here we have our built-in microphone, and just next to it a small panel to house our ports. Again we have a 3.5mm audio input and a micro USB charging port, and this time around we also have a reset button. Unlike the Motion Q, the XB10's base features a rubberized texture to prevent slipping, and we also have some vents here to assist the passive radiator. The final external feature is the loophole and included strap, which has been designed to allow the speaker to rest horizontally across the rubber loop. This design choice is actually really important for maximizing audio quality, but I'll talk in more detail about this later on. A quick press on the power button initiates pairing mode, and the speaker will search for the last connected device. If you're adding another XB10, press and hold the add button to start stereo pairing. Repeat this on the second device, and after a short time, the two speakers will pair. Pressing the add button on either speaker will cycle through the different playback modes, as indicated by the LEDs. Here you'll be able to swap the left and right channels in stereo, or select a dual playback mode in which both speakers play both channels. Again, turning off one speaker will automatically turn off the other as well. As with the Motion Q, we have our typical playback controls which can be used on either speaker, and the microphone is restricted to the main speaker for phone calls and your voice assistant. Personally, I feel as though the XB10 is a much better looking speaker than the Motion Q. However, the rubber exterior doesn't quite offer the same protection and can be prone to fingerprints. Controls did offer a satisfying click when pressed, but these were less accessible and more difficult to use. I did find though that the microphone was much more sensitive to my voice commands and was much better during phone calls. At 249 grams, the XB10 also comes in a much smaller and lighter package than the Motion Q, and is far easier to transport. All design factors considered, Sony's XB10 is the more elegant, but perhaps less practical of the two speakers. And now to our third and final speaker, the UE Wonderboom. And the first thing you'll notice here is that I'll actually be unboxing the two-pack bundle, but those of you buying a single Wonderboom can expect a similar unboxing. The twin pack features the black and grey speakers, but the Wonderboom is available in a wide variety of colour options. So after removing the outer sleeve, we can open up the box to reveal our two speakers. In typical UE fashion, we have the extra large volume controls mounted to the fabric exterior. So here we have similar material choices to the Anker Motion Q. I would say though that the Wonderboom does feel firmer and is definitely the more robust and durable of the three speakers. Consequently, and despite being very easy to locate, the volume buttons are quite difficult to press. This requires a lot of force and doesn't give the same clicky feedback as with the other two speakers. Just like the Motion Q, we have plastic base and surface panels, the latter of which features a small colour matched loop. These aren't removable and are probably a little bit small to be practical for more than a small handful of uses. The Wonderboom's control system is stripped down and simple. The top button can be long pressed to invoke pairing mode, indicated by the inner LED. In the centre we have a multi-function button for play pause and to skip tracks forward. And finally at the bottom we have the power button, which also contains a white LED. Again, these buttons are a little difficult to press, which, despite the simple control scheme, makes the Wonderboom the most difficult to use of the three speakers. Just like the XB10 and Motion Q, a small panel protects the speaker's inputs, which in this case is only the micro USB charging port, so there are no other audio input options here. My main issue with this charging port is that it sits too deep into the speaker, and this can make it very difficult to connect the USB cable to charge the device. Speaking of which, the accessories can be found underneath the speakers. You won't find much in terms of paperwork with only the safety and warranty information, but of course we do get a rather vibrant neon yellow micro USB cable for each speaker. Two Wonderbooms can be paired up to provide a dual playback. To do this, turn on both devices and press and hold the multifunction button until you hear a short tone to indicate double up mode. Unfortunately, there are no options for stereo playback, so both speakers will play both audio channels. Unlike the other two speakers, turning off a speaker will not auto turn off the other speaker, which I guess can be looked at as either a pro or a con. Design-wise, the Wonderboom is essentially a slightly heavier but more robust version of Anker's Motion Q. The Wonderboom has the added protection of drop testing from 5 meters, and I'd certainly trust this or the Motion Q to stand their ground outdoors over Sony's XB10, where the speaker itself is really well protected, but is much more prone to marks or scratches. The dark grey Motion Q offers a professional looking speaker, in contrast to the Wonderboom's striking bold colour options, which are certainly much more fun. Overall, the Motion Q was the easiest speaker to use, with both other speakers, particularly the Wonderboom, having fiddly, hard-to-press buttons. The Motion Q is also the only speaker of the three that is able to skip tracks backwards as well as forwards. The XB10 was the most portable and aesthetically pleasing speaker, but the Wonderboom was the most durable and perhaps has the best design for its intended use. Moving on to water resistance, only Anker and UE speakers are fully waterproof, with IPX7 ratings allowing full submersion up to 1 meter. Both speakers also float, so you don't have to worry about losing these at the lake or in the pool. Sony's XB10 is only rated at IPX5, allowing for protection against powerful jets of water, but unfortunately not against full submersion. Looking at connectivity, the Motion Q was the weakest of the three speakers, with a Bluetooth line of sight distance at around 55 feet. Connection between a pair of Motion Qs was, however, very good, with no syncing issues at all. The XB10 fared only marginally better with a line of sight distance of 60 feet before dropout started to occur. Disappointingly though, the XB10 did intermittently drop out and then instantly reconnect when paired with the other speaker, and this was with the speakers set only a few feet apart. The audio synchronization was completely fine, but those occasional dropouts did noticeably interrupt my music. UE claim a Bluetooth range of 100 feet, but from my testing I achieved a line of sight distance at a staggering 200 feet, blowing away both the XB10 and the Motion Q. In double up mode, the speakers also fared very well, with no sync or dropout issues whatsoever. The Wonderboom's superior connection also provided the shortest delay between pressing the controls on the speaker and my music corresponding with a pause, change of track, or volume change. It also handled rapidly alternating speakers to control playback. Occasionally, both the XB10 and Motion Q required me to repeat the button press in order to trigger the command. The Wonderboom had no issues here at all. In terms of battery, the Motion Q delivers on its 10-hour battery life claim, and I managed just over this amount, listening at volumes slightly above 50%. The charging time to battery life ratio, however, is quite poor, taking around 3.5 hours for a complete charge. Sony's XB10 battery was the best of the three speakers, providing a pretty accurate 16 hours of playback from a charge time of just over 4 hours. The Wonderboom charged in around 3 hours, and gave an honest 10 hours of playback at 50% volume. However, this was pretty impressive given that this is already louder than even the max volume of some other small speakers. Moving on to audio quality, for a budget speaker particularly of this size, the Motion Q's audio quality is quite good. In fact, the speaker's bright mid-range is very good, and vocals in particular are clear and distinct. As with many small speakers, the low end is the weakest point, and despite the bass-up technology, the bass here isn't very strong. The speaker sounds much better at higher volumes to compensate for this, and these can get very loud, certainly louder than the XB10. Maxing out the volume does lead to slight distortion, but for most situations this shouldn't be necessary, particularly if using a pair of Motion Qs. The 360-degree audio is also pretty even, and the speaker does a good job of projecting the sound. Only by carefully listening up close can you notice whether you're facing one of the alternating drivers or radiators, and this was the same with the UE Wonderboom. If the Motion Q's audio quality is good, then the XB10's is excellent. Sony takes the great mid-range of the Motion Q and enriches it with greater clarity and detail. Vocals are crisp, instruments are distinctive, and the sound profile overall is much more well-balanced. The biggest difference here is that the low end, driven by Sony's extra bass technology, adds body to the sound. Where the Motion Q's audio could seem a little thin, this provides the speaker with a much fuller sound experience. The smallest of the three speakers, the XB10 packs an impressive amount of punch in the bass, which is much more prominent than in the Motion Q, despite not being able to reach the same high volume levels. That's not to say that the XB10's max volume isn't impressive, and in fact the audio at max volume is much more stable and doesn't suffer from the same issues with distortion whatsoever. One caveat here though is that due to the speaker's lightweight design, songs with heavy bass played at high volumes can cause the speaker to move, and this can lead to rattling on some surfaces. This can give the illusion of bass distortion, and this does spoil the audio quality. Sony's solution for this lies in the attached carry loop. Laying the speaker on its side not only eliminates the rattling issue, but having the audio directed towards you massively enhances the richness and bass of the audio. The drawback of this, however, is that by laying it down you do lose the 360-degree audio experience, so sharing your XB10's audio amongst a group of friends becomes a lot more difficult. Certainly the XB10 suffers the most from this small speaker limitation. With the UE Wonderboom, an emphasis is placed on the low end, so much like the XB10, the speaker offers much deeper bass and full-bodied sound compared to the Motion Q. Whilst the XB10's bass is more focused and controlled, the sheer volume and punch of the Wonderboom provides deeper bass than with Sony's speaker. something which is much more prominent at higher volumes. UE's speaker can reach incredibly high volume levels, perhaps the loudest of any speaker of this size. The detail, however, isn't quite as good as the XB10, and the mid-range and vocals in particular have slightly less clarity. The low-end frequencies are perhaps boosted a little too much compared to the others, which muddies the sound. But for some bass-heavy songs, this can sound really good. For most songs, however, the Wonderboom suffers from this frequency imbalance compared to the XB10, but still prevails over Anker's Motion Q. So now let's take a listen to some audio samples from the speakers themselves. Remember, of course, that listening to these speakers recorded through my microphone and played through your speakers isn't going to give an accurate representation, but hopefully will give you some idea about the differences in the audio quality. All three speakers are playing at 50% volume, so do listen out for differences in loudness. As always, listening through headphones is strongly recommended. Overall, the XB10 has a more well-balanced sound profile, and is technically the best of the speakers in terms of audio quality. At higher volumes though, these subtle nuances can be harder to detect, and so the Wonderboom's louder, bass-focused output could be the better option. Anker's Motion Q is definitely a great speaker. For the price, it's one of the best small speakers on the market, and its robust build quality and full waterproofing make it a fantastic choice for a durable outdoor speaker. Any of the three speakers can fill a small to medium-sized room, and all benefit from doubling up with a second speaker. But those looking to really liven up the party should probably look to Wonderboom's superior volume, and I'd personally opt to pay that little bit extra to secure the better audio quality over the Motion Q. Sony's XB10 definitely tempted me with its excellent compact design and improved battery life, but those intermittent dropouts and lack of full waterproofing were enough to deter me. With all things considered, the UE Wonderboom's loud, punchy sound and rugged build quality make it my choice for the best small Bluetooth speaker. But what do you guys think about these speakers? Let me know in the comments what your choice is for the best small speaker. If you enjoyed the video, then please give it a like, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. That's it for this video, and I'll see you all in the next one.